So indeed, we're the first country in the world at deploying a BVLOS network. And like all great stories, it all starts with a dream. And this was the dream of our CEO, Mitch de Geest. He's also a volunteer fireman. And he had the dream 5 years ago that drones could be added to his platoon. But he didn't want to miss somebody out of the platoon controlling the drone. So he asked one of our guys, or one of technical guys, can you make a drone that can be controlled from a distance? And that was the whole concept born of the drone in a box network all over Belgium. Then we start looking for partners. We hooked up with Nokia and we start doing the first tests. And after the first test, we did a project with the government in Belgium for 5G subsidies. And we submitted an idea of deploying 70 of these drones in a box all over Belgium. So the idea is that we install 70 crossover Belgium. They will be controlled from 5 remote operation centers by 40 pilots in total. That was their idea. And funny enough, it was agreed. They went for it because all the drones are also controlled over 5G and 4G. So that was the idea, that was a concept, how it's going now. In the meantime, we have just installed our 40th box. So still mean that we still have 30 to go. We have 4 remote operation centers active, spread over the country, and 9 pilots that are controlling the drones. We did a lot of flights already in last year. We did 303 flights for the fire department. And we ramped up the beginning of this year, meaning that already as of today, half of the year, we had more than 1,000 flights that we did for the fire department. And that experience of these 1,300 flights that we already did for the fire experience, for the firemen, really proved that this drone in a box network brings added value to the first responders in Belgium. So we currently offer it as a service. That means that we have a direct link with the dispatch center, so with the 112. The moment that a distress call comes in with the 112, they automatically activate a fire truck, and at the same time, the drone is activated. 2 minutes after the call, the drone is at the incident, providing an overview for the first responders. They receive the stream in the dispatch or on their tablet or phone in the car. And all this is offered as a service to the fire department, so they don't need to work or think about the hardware, they don't need to think about the maintenance, they just, the moment there is a fire, we fly for them, we provide them the images, and that's it, as a service. And what we see, there are two main added values that we can provide to them. The first one is because we're first at scene, mean that we see things that they couldn't see before. This means that, for instance, if there is a fire at one side of the highway and the call was for the other side of the highway, we can direct them directly to the right side of the highway, saving minutes of time. So minutes in a fire are really crucial because that can save the building or even lives. That's one use case. The other use case is that we see a lot of fire departments that have their own drone team. We are there up front. They have all the time to deploy their own drone team. They do the intervention, but after the intervention, I mean, if the fire is out, the drone team is already to another intervention, and then they recall the drone just to have an overview of the hotspots. Is everything clear? And then afterwards, like 2-3 hours after the big fire, once again, they call the drone. The drone flies over and see and make sure there are no hotspots left. So that's another use case that we can do. So for the large interventions. And then the third one is just providing crucial info the moment that they are attacking a fire. So that they see what's going on the back of a building, what's going on the road, all those things. So most added value is giving them extra insights minutes before they're even at the scene. And even if they're at the scene, they can use the aerial view to have an overview and to make better decisions. In the society where we're living today, dual use is the key word. everybody has to invest in their defense. And we have to invest more in defense. But with this, you can invest in public safety today, meaning you provide a drone grid over a country, helping police, fire departments, and hospitals doing their activities in a more safe way, and making sure that we also can ensure the national security tomorrow. I mean that this is really a dual use case, because you can invest today, you have the benefit today of the investment by the use of the fire department and the police. And tomorrow, if there is a big emergency, the military can use the network to have an overview in 2 minutes from one side to the other side in the country what's happening. So I definitely would advise every country to invest in a drone network. There are two very important things. First of all, it's really important the regulations is on place, because unlikely other things, drones are handled on a European level. So there is European regulation in place, and as a local authority, you have to follow those European laws, EASA rules about the use of drones, and especially the use of BVLOS drones, so beyond visual line of sight. There's still a big gap in regulation today. So that's the first thing that needs to be in place. The second thing is you need to convince the local teams that this is an add-on, that there's a complementarity between this service and the local teams, that one and one here truly becomes three.